Hello, good morning, and welcome to this Lean Processing webinar. So today we will have a look to our specific software dedicated to manage images, documents, and metadata. Lean Processing is really dedicated to send document into a specific workflow and manage images, documents, metadata at the same time in order to ingest, process, do quality control, document validation and sampling, and then OCR and exporting in multiple kind of export format. And then, of course, publishing. So let's go with this Lean Processing webinar, and let's have a look right now to the Lean Processing user interface. So here we are connected to Lean Processing server version. So this is the main user interface, and here we have access to the dashboard of the solution. So this main user interface will display all the different documents available into the queue, and each line will represent a document waiting for some user to process or check the quality control. So each line will represent a document. A document can be a book, it can be a map, or it can be a set of images. So for each line, you can see the number of pages and what is the user in charge of this document. Then you have some columns available. Each columns will represent a step into the workflow. So starting from the import until the export and the publishing. So we have around 10 different steps. So two are mandatory, import and export. Then all the other steps are optional. So if you want to do image processing, quality control, document validation, you just validate the steps into the job creation in order to add this feature to your document. So we are going to create a new project and see step by step what are the key features for each step and see what we can do on the document with Lean Processing. So here I will click on new project, and I will create a new job, and I will apply a specific template. Template is a set of pre-existing settings that you can choose from the user interface. So here I will add a folder of images. So I will select on my computer some images. So I will select a full directory of images. So let's choose this one, for example. Okay, I can select one or several directories of images. And I will apply to this set of images a template, which means I will import and ingest specific metadata. I will do some specific image processing, quality control, structuring, OCR, export, and then publishing on our digital repository, Lean Gallery. So I will just start the document and based on this existing settings, the document will start to run into the queue and will be added to the dashboard and start to run into the user interface. So as you can see, the job has been added to the last line of the dashboard. And all images has been automatically imported, and automatically we have imported also the metadata link to our images. So after the first step of the import, the document will go into the second step, which is the image processing, and automatically all images from the document will be processed based on the settings we have choose into the job creation. Third step is the quality control. So we have automatic quality control for the image processing steps. Okay, it means that based on our settings, we can check that all automatic processes are correctly done on the images. As you can see now, the job has stopped into the quality control step, waiting for the user to check the result of this automatic processes. So I will just double click on the document in order to open this document into the quality control step. So here we have access to the quality control step. And on the left side, we can see all the thumbnails from our document available. Okay. So here you can quickly see all the pages of our document. Okay. In the middle part of the user interface, we have three different view of the images. So on the top right side, we have the original image of the document. Okay. On the bottom right side, we have the final image after all the automatic process. Okay. And in the central part, we have the image as it is when we select the list of processes that we have applied to our images into the document. So here on the right side, we have a list of processes that have been applied to the full document, all pages of the document. So we have started with the first page detection on the document, then a crop, and then a remove background. Okay. And here on the right side of our screen, we have the list of all available processes to process our book images. Okay, so the idea of this step is to check the result of automatic controls, automatic processes done on the images. So you can move and check your result choosing the thumbnails on the left side and see if the quality of the process is okay with your requirements. So as you can see on the thumbnails, we have some green check in order to give some information to the operator and say that the document seems to be okay based on the result of the processing we have on this image. Also, you have some yellow check, okay, that will give you some information like a blank page, blur, or bad detection. And of course, you can filter all the thumbnail based on this kind of warning. So these are warnings to help the operator to see if there is no error in the page detection. So for example, here we have a bad crop on the image. So we can go back into the process history and check what kind of process has not been done correctly on the page. So we can manually adjust the position of the page detection for this one. Okay. And automatically we can see that the final image has been updated. Okay. And now we are satisfied with the result of the final image. Okay, so at any time I can filter and see images with good results images with a warning icon in order to filter and see if I need to do some manual reprocessing on my pages. Okay. This part of the software is also dedicated to apply a specific process to one or several pages of the document. Okay. So for example, for the cover, if I need to apply a specific process for the cover, I can easily do this using the process available on the right side. So for example, for the cover, I will do a manual selection and maybe only a crop, and I will keep the image in color. So I can do the same for all the other images. So once I'm satisfied with the result of the quality control, then I can click on the next button available at the top right, and the document will leave from the quality control to the next step, which is the document validation. So the operator will open the document into the document validation. Once again, he will have an overview of all the thumbnails for the document, okay, and with a direct access to each page of the book. Okay, so the document validation will allow us to check the page number of each image of our document and to see if there is no missing pages or double pages during the scan process. So for this, we will use the automatic pagination feature available here in the toolbar. And we will define the position of left page and right page number, okay, in order to help the OCR engine to extract the information from each page of the document. So OCR engine will extract this information and will show us the result on each page of the document. So as you can see, we have been able to extract the information for each page. So here you can see, for example, the crop on the page. Here we have the OCR extraction. Okay, and then we have the software validation for the number of each page of the document. So of course, if there is some error, we can manually change the results. Or we can validate the page using the button here to validate page by page. So as you can see, we are able to jump from 44 to 45, even if you have two pages here without any number available. So I will validate, and then we will number virtually all pages of the document. Okay, so you can quickly go to the last pages, okay, and check that the virtual number is equal to the physical number of the page available here into the bottom part of the page. So this feature will be very useful to check missing pages or double pages. But also it will be required if we want to do some structuring on the document into the next steps. So once this is done, I will click on Next, and the document will go on and will move from document validation to sampling steps. So let's open now the document into the sampling. So the sampling is a step dedicated to check the results of the original page versus the final image. So the operator will click on Next Sample to see some samples of the images, and one by one it will check the original image and see if the final image has all the good settings we are waiting for. Okay. As you can see on the right side, we have some tags available for the images. So we have some existing tags from the automatic quality control step. Okay, so we can untag the image if the image is correct. If we can see some error into the image, then we can tag the image with some existing tag like blur, framing, blank page, or bad desk view. And then you can reject the image if the image is not correct. Okay. Then, of course, you can add a note to the document. Okay. You can imagine that you can say that image number 45, I don't know, has bad desk view. Okay. So you can save this note. Okay. As an administrator or as an operator of the software, and this information will follow the document, and the supervisor will be aware of that one of the images is not correct, and some work has to be done to rescan or reprocess this image. So at any time you can tag the image with existing tags, and you can also create your own tags into this area to improve the information about each image of the document. So here we will check 10% of the document. Then from the job creation, you will be able to decide if you want to make a sampling on the full document, on 10%, 20%, or on a specific number of images. So at the end of the sampling, the software will generate automatically a report of the sampling. Okay, this report can be exported as a PDF with the document. And in this report, you will see all the defects and all the statistics about the sampling report, with all defects on the images, what kind of defects, and what is the percentage for each type of defect detected on the images. Okay, so this is it for the sampling. So we'll quit the sampling, and the job will continue and go into the structuring step. Okay, so once again, the operator will open the document into the structuring step. Okay, and here we will be able to create and edit the structure of the document. So just like before, we retrieve all the thumbnails of our document. You can move from one page to another. And on the right side, you have the default structure available for the document. Okay. So of course, you can create chapter manually. So adding chapter for each part of the structure, you can edit and change the chapter name, the type of chapter, if it is a chapter, a content, an index, and so on. So you can completely design your structure for your document. But what is interesting is that we can use the table of content of the document to extract the information from this image. So we will use the automatic table of content feature to analyze the image with the OCR engine. In order to extract the chapter name and the page number for each chapter. So here you can see the result of the auto table extraction. We can change the region of interest, okay, and automatically on the right side you can see that we have extracted the chapter name and the chapter level but also the page number of each chapter. Okay, so if we have some bad OCR results from the OCR engine, of course we can modify manually this OCR results, okay, and validate the chapter name. Okay, so once I'm okay, I can validate the structure of the document. And when I validate, I will see the structure that will appear on the right side of the screen. And automatically, all pages have been moved to the correct position into the document structure. So here I have access to all my chapters. And for each chapter, I can see all the pages that will go into the correct position. Of course, if I need to change the position of images into the structure, I can select each page and manually drag and drop the page into the correct position. So for example, this one is the title. I will drag and drop this page to the title, okay, and automatically retrieve the page at the correct position. Okay, last pages of the document will go into the last chapter or last position. Okay, I will move it here. Okay, and I will use the last image as the cover. Okay, so here we have the copyright. I will move it down to the copyright position. This one is the content. I will move it here. Okay. So once the structure is done, I can move. Okay. And we will go on with the next step, which is the first step of the OCR with the segmentation. So the job now is running into the segmentation step. So segmentation step is automatic. Okay. This is the very first part of the OCR where we define all the different block text position and block images position into the images. So now I will wait. I will open the document into the segmentation module. Okay, and we will see the result of the OCR segmentation on this document. So here we can see all the thumbnails of the pages on the left side. And for each pages, we now have access to the segmentation OCR results. So we can see in yellow all the text block detected by the OCR engine. And in green, you will see all the images block detection from the OCR. So the idea of the segmentation is to give access to the operator to the result of the OCR segmentation so that the operator can modify the block text detection and image block detection. Okay, you can modify the position of text block to adjust from the OCR results. Okay, in order to improve the quality of the OCR at the end. Also, you can merge text block together. You can split text block. You can resize all the text block. Okay, you can redefine new text zone into the image. Okay, and also reorder the text zone. Okay, which is important when you will OCR some newspaper and if you want to export text file, it's very important to have the correct order for the text block. if you want to keep the order of reading on your document. Okay, so we will validate the segmentation and we will go out of the segmentation window and the job will continue to run into the lean processing workflow, going into the next step, which is now the OCR extraction of the each page of the document. So what is interesting with lean processing is that it's a multi-core dedicated product. Okay, so here if I open my task manager, I can see that we have 16 cores on this server, okay, and now all cores are dedicated to the OCR step, okay. But if you want to work on another document, okay, some cores will be dedicated to other tasks. So it means that while the document is running into the OCR, you can still continue to work on other documents waiting for the user to check the quality control or to check the sampling or document validation. So job now is waiting for the user to check the result of the OCR. Okay, so I will open the document into the OCR quality control. So just like before, we have access to all thumbnails of the document. Okay, so I can select image one by one. And then for each image, I can select the text block and sees my result of my OCR into the dedicated dialog box on the right side of the screen. Okay, so we can highlight all words that are out of the dictionary in red, for example. We have access to all OCR statistics for the selected page, for the whole page. And see how many words, how many characters have been detected, and what are the accuracy for the page. Of course, if you can see some bad OCR detection, you can modify the text and edit the text, okay, and correct the OCR. Manually and adjust one by one each word of the text. Just like in the quality control of the image processing, we have filters available. Okay, so you can define the minimum percentage accuracy you like into the document result, and then filter all documents with 0% result or document with minimum level that you want to access. Okay, so you can filter pages with good results and pages with bad results in order to easily see which pages has not been detected correctly by the OCR. Okay, let's move from the OCR quality control step. And now the document will run into the export, multiple format export. And here the document will be outputted in PDF, JPEG, TIFF, METS, and whatever the format we have decided to output. So while this document is running into the export, I will be able to open any of the existing documents in my dashboard in order to make some quality control, for example, on this document available here. Okay, so the export is running, and while the export is running, I can do some quality control on another document using some dedicated cores of the computer to make some adjustment on the page detection, desk queue, and crop, for example. Okay, so here I continue to work into the quality control step for this new document. And if I get back to the current dashboard, okay, in the bottom part of the dashboard, I can see my document running into the export step. So depending on the size of your document and of course on the hardware resources from your server, it will take several seconds to several minutes to process and export your document all around the different steps you have choose into your workflow. So here we have seen all the different steps, okay, but you can use in processing very simply with only few steps. So if we create while this job is running, we will create another one with less images. Okay, let's use this one. Okay, and I can use this job to do only image conversion. Okay, so let's say I will add this job and make only export to JPEG or JPEG 2000. Okay. Okay, so here I will add this new document and I will only dedicated LIMP processing to make some image conversion from TIFF to JPEG. So here my new document will run into the workflow. Okay, but we'll go from very first step import directly to the last step, which is the export, and we'll convert images from TIFF to JPEG. So depending on your requirements or needs, you can use LIMP processing to make a lot of feature on your document, like image processing, quality control, document validation. But also you can use it very basically to make some image conversion from one format to another. Okay, and as you can see, if you have some cores available on your computer, you will be able to manage two, three, four, five different jobs at the same time. With some dedicated cores assigned to one of the job or one of the steps on the workflow. Yeah, I see. So now the document has finished the export step and then automatically go on with the publishing step to publish directly on LIMP Gallery the online solution to manage your digital library. So in a few seconds, we will have access to the exporting output from Lean Processing, and then after a few minutes, the document will be uploaded into Gallery for the publishing results. So now the job is finished. As you can see, the green check is on the document name. And once it is finished, the document will move from the current dashboard to the Finish tab available here. So now I can open the document into the Finish tab and go directly to the output directory. And I can see all the different documents we have outputted with Lean Processing. So here for this sample, we have outputted the Metz file. Okay, so we can edit the Metz and see all the metadata information for the document and all metadata information for each page of the document and any information we have added to the Metz, like the structure and so on. So we have the Metz, we have the table of content from the structuring, okay, with all the chapter, name, level, and position with page number. We have access to the TIFF file. So all TIFF archive. We have the JPEG. We have the Dublin Core metadata, okay, with all information about the document. We have the ALTO results from the OCR. Okay, with all word position and all information from the OCR extraction. And a last one is the PDF output. Okay. So here, as you can see, we have all pages from the PDF. Okay. And for the left side of the PDF, we have all bookmarks with the chapter access used by the structuring. So we have created the structure of the document with the automatic table of content extraction from Lean Processing. So of course, this is a searchable PDF. Okay, so we can copy and paste the text and we can search for text inside the PDF. Okay, so this is it for this document. So we have processed a full book of images. We have ingest metadata with the images. We have made some quality control, document validation and sampling, then structuring all the documents, making some segmentation and OCR, in order to export in several kind of format. And we have published the document on our Limgallery repository. So I can show you the result now into our demo gallery website. So this is Limgallery, our online solution. And if I go now to the records page, I will search for my document. Okay. And I will be able to find it here into the main records page. And I will retrieve all my pages from the document we have uploaded a few seconds ago. Okay. And I will see all my pages and all the text results, OCR bookmarks available with the document. So in a few minutes, we were able to convert some images from a book to a virtual book available on the web with all information extracted from the document. Okay, so let's go on with the Lean processing presentation and let's have a look to another feature which is interesting with Lean processing is what we call the hot folder. So hot folder is a dedicated folder for a specific task. Okay, so as you can see here in the hot folder tab, we have three different hot folder and each hot folder so is linked to a specific directory on the server. Okay, so here for example I will go to the same directory which is input demo gbs hot and resize. Okay, so here I have already two books, so I can remove them. Okay, and if I go back and copy some files into this directory. Okay, so I will copy one book into this directory. Then automatically, if I go back to the main dashboard, I will see the job that will appear into the main user interface. So the idea is that each time we add a new document into this hot folder, automatically the job will be added into the main user interface. Okay, and automatically the previous job that has been added to this hot folder will start to run into the Lean processing software. So the interest of this is that you don't have to be in front of the Lean processing computer. You just need to copy a set of images into a specific directory. Automatically, Lean processing will monitor this directory, and each time Lean processing can see a new set of data into this directory, it will be processed by Lean processing with the current template assigned to this directory. So if you create a directory to do some resize, each new set of data copied into this directory will be resized into the specific format you are waiting for in the output. Okay, so this is an interesting feature of the software where you can define several hot folder assign each folder to a specific step or task. Okay, so you can create auth folder to do resize, publishing, conversion, and so on. Now let's have a look at the project creation. So here in the project creation, you can easily add any kind of image into your project, and then use the different settings for each step in order to output document and images as you like. So you retrieve, just like in the dashboard, all the different steps from import to publishing with the image processing, quality control, structuring, OCR, and export. Okay. For each step, if you want to do some image processing, you just have to check the step here. Okay. Same thing for quality control, OCR, and so on. Okay. So if you want only to make import and export, then you ch uncheck everything. Then if you want to do some of the steps, you check and then you modify the settings within each step. So let's have a look to the different steps. So the very first one is import. You can filter the image based on the format. So if you want to process only JPEG, TIFF, PNG, and so on, you select which one you want to use or not. In this area, you define if you will use a simple page or double page. Okay, if it is a double page, then you will define what will be the very first page to start with. In the import step, what is nice is that you can define how you will manage metadata. So you can manage metadata by file, which means that automatically, if there is some metadata file with your images, it can be a mark, a dublin core, a CSV, or mods. Okay, automatically, we will ingest the file metadata with the images into the LIMP processing software. Second option is a CSV option. So we can define a global CSV in order to set several documents at the same time into a global CSV and automatically import the metadata based on the unique identifier of the document. Third option is a catalog connection through a Z39 metadata server. Okay. So for example, you can choose what kind of server you will use and then connect to this server and search for a specific fields or a specific ID number to retrieve the document you are looking for. Okay, so then we retrieve the document name and all metadata, and we can ingest this information with the images into LIMP processing. Last option is the manual option. So of course you can use the existing metadata available in the dublin core, in the mark, in the mods, and manually enter your metadata information during the import step or during the quality control step of the workflow. You can also customize your metadata by adding any fields, personal fields into the custom fields, okay, and assign specific values to this field. Okay, so if Dublin Core mods marks is not enough, then you can create your own custom fields and assign these values manually or automatically, depending on the link between this metadata and yours. We have access also into the import step to the image metadata customization. So we have access to the exe for IPTC. So we can apply existing metadata from the Dublin Core or from the custom field to all image exif metadata. Okay. So for example, here for each image description metadata from the exif, we can assign the document metadata for the description. Okay. And we can do this for all exif and IPTC values. Okay. So for example, I can set the Dublin Core creator value from the document and assign this metadata to the exif artist metadata. So I can do this also for the IPTC. And also I can do this for the custom fields. So I can create custom fields to the image metadata also. So we have two levels for the metadata. We have a document metadata level and we have an image metadata level. So you can access both and you can customize both. In the import step, we can link a document to Maestro. So we can activate or not the Maestro connection from Lean Processing. So this option will be interesting if you want to monitor a job that goes into Lean Processing and follow this document into Maestro. By activating this step, you will monitor the document and see how it goes inside Lean Processing. So second step settings is the image processing. So here you will define what kind of process you will apply to all image of the document. So when you create a project, you will use this step to test and apply the different processing available. So here on the left side we have all list of process, okay? And I will be able to select one of the page of my document, okay? And test the process I want to apply. So maybe on this one, I will make a desk queue, a page detection. Then I will apply the settings. Okay, so desk queue can be made on the text line, on the page border. So the idea is to test the process and check which one has the best settings. Okay, so I can apply my page detection, define if I want some margin inside or outside of the document, and then apply my settings, okay. Make a desk queue, crop the image, okay. Then remove the background, for example. Okay. Then maybe I can come back to the page detection and define different settings for my margin. Okay, so at any time I can come back and change the settings, okay, in order to find the best position or best process I want to apply to my document. Okay, so here, for example, I will make margin detection. Okay, and then maybe center the document into the page. Okay. So of course I can then move from one page to another and check the result on the other page. So if it's fine, then I can validate and apply this to the full document when I will launch the document using the start button at the end of the document creation. Next step is the quality control. So here I can validate or not the quality control. I can decide to activate automatic quality control using the blank page detection, incorrect page detection, blur detection, overexposure detection, but also low resolution detection. Okay, so I can define a minimum resolution for all my images. And if I do not reach this minimum resolution, I will have a warning on each image. Then we have the manual quality control. I can activate or not. If I activate, then all documents will stop into the quality control step, waiting for the user to check the quality result of the automatic processes. Quality control sampling, I can activate and decide to make a sampling on the full document on a percentage, so 10-20% of the book, okay, or a fixed number of pages. So when I validate the sampling, then the operator will have to the document will stop into the sampling step, and the operator will have to validate a fixed number of pages or a percentage or the full document. You choose how many pages will be checked by the operator. Last settings is the document validation. You activate or not if you want to access to the page numbering and stop into the document validation. So next step is the structuring. Okay, so here you define what kind of OCR engine you will use to make the structuring, what kind of language will be used, and you can also load and create your own structure. Okay, so you can define you can predefine a structure, and of course save and load different structure if you don't want to use the automatic extraction of the structure management. You can create your structure here and load it from any XML file. Next step is the OCR. Okay, so you define if you want to make OCR or not, what kind of OCR engine you will use between Iris, ABBYY, or Tesseract. Okay, then you choose the language to search. You can search up to four languages into the same document. Okay, and depending on the OCR engine, you will be able to access more than 100 languages, 100 different languages. And then you can activate the OCR quality assurance. So it means the document will stop in after the OCR process in order to check the result of the OCR. Same thing for the segmentation. You can activate or not the segmentation quality in order to check the result of segmentation. And you can use also user dictionary in order to improve the result of the OCR and using external dictionary. Last step, one of the last step is the export. One of the most important step of Lean processing, with multiple export format and completely customizable export. So here we have in this box the list of all export format available with the metadata, with Dublin Core, MARC, MIX, MODS, CSV, OCR, table of content and quality report. Okay. Then images with BMP, source image, JPEG 2000, JPEG, PNG, TIFF, and mixed image files. And then the document with multiple TIFF image file, ALTO, PDF, METS, plain text, XML, HTML, Word, raw XML, and MAG format. So this is all the available format on the left box. On the right box, these are the format choose by the operator to export. So here, for example, we have some settings to export Dublin Core, table of content, TIFF, JPEG, METS, PDF, and ALTO. So if I want to export several TIFF or JPEG at the same time, I just need to select one more time for the JPEG. Okay. Then I will give a new name to this JPEG output. I will call it JPEG resize, for example. I will reduce the quality for this JPEG to 50. And I will, for example, resize to 72 dpi. Okay, so at the same time, I'm able to output TIFF without compression, a good JPEG quality at 80%, and a low-level quality JPEG, a second one, at 50% with a resize at 72 dpi for the web. So if you want multiple TIFF, multiple JPEG with different kind of output, you just select the format and modify the settings into the right box of exported format. Depending on the format, you will have access to quality compression, ICC profile, resize, and color mode, which means that you can output JPEG in color and at the same time, type JPEG in grayscale or binary. So depending on the format, you will have access to different settings. So TIFF with no compression, LZW compression, TIFF-J4 for the binary images, still resize and color mode for the TIFF, and different kind of format and settings for the PDF, for example, where you can output PDF with image and text, text only, image only, and so on. Some formats will have specific settings with customization. For example, for the CSV, you will have advanced configuration for the CSV or for the METS, where you can define your own format output. Okay, so you can create your own fields and add your own fields to the CSV using the existing metadata information from LIMB. Okay, so at any time I can add some information from any metadata available in LIMB and add this information to the CSV output. Okay, so I can customize my CSV output. Same thing for the METS output. I can customize the METS with the advanced configuration. So for all outputs, I can see here the preview of the output with the main directory, then the directory name for my document. Okay, and then each level for the TIFF, the JPEG, PDF, DC, ALTO file, and so on. Okay, but all this can be customized. So I can modify the format label. I can modify the main folder name using some metadata. Same thing for the file naming. I can rename the output. And I can also use some metadata information to add into the file naming or into the document directory name. So for example, here I can add the identifier of the document to the METS output, okay? And here I will retrieve this identifier value just close to the document name. Okay, so I can completely customize all output, name, and settings for document, metadata, images, and so on. Very last step is publishing. Okay, so we have three different ways to publish document on an external server. So the first option is the FTP. Okay, so you can activate the FTP output using a standard FTP connection and define which format you will output to the FTP. Second option is a LimGallery connection. Okay, so of course for this you need a LimGallery account where you can select your account and select this account, define which templates in LimGallery you will use, okay, and define which format will be uploaded on the web. Okay, so just using the box from the export and choosing which format will be uploaded on the LimGallery website. Last way to publish is to use a LibSafe account. Okay, same thing for preservation. If you have a LibSafe solution, then you can connect Lim Processing to your LibSafe account and using the Samba protocol to export one or several formats at the same time into the LibSafe publishing preservation account. So once you have done all these settings with your job, okay, you can save all these settings into a template, okay, so save as, and define the name of the template that will be used to save all the settings. So the idea is to create a set of templates, okay, and each one will have a specific steps and specific task for your project, okay, and you can save all these settings from the 10 steps and all settings for each step into a template. Okay, so then you can move from one template to another to make specific tasks on your document. Okay, so the idea is to create several templates with specific tasks, and then the next time you have to do a specific task on a document, you will use a predefined template and apply it to all your new documents in order to output the document in TIFF, in JPEG, and to publish maybe or output some OCR results on your document.